results in creation of different teams, duplicating their efforts, results in high cost of complaints. Where our product comes into play, where it helps in automating the complete process. It also helps to follow complaints as a culture in your organization. So, FreshGRC is an IT integrated tool which is going to help streamline your internal audit lifecycle, eliminating the redundancies and irregularities and the paperwork. So, in any organization when you're going to take, there will be a hierarchy of employees like super admin, admin, auditor, audities. So, this is communicating between the auditor and the auditee or the manager and the employee. So, in an organization, the auditor will have to communicate to multiple auditees, which cannot be done in a regulated manner. So, you need a tool which will help streamline the process. So, let me quickly walk you through the product. So, I've logged in user as an auditor here. So, this is the dashboard overlook. So, here in this dashboard, you'll be able to view the different types of audit, maybe the internal and the external audit here. The audit status, which is being pending and which is passed and which is failed here. And you'll have a monthly wise report of the audit process. And here you'll have the department wise, like the development, the sales, you'll have a different department wise and the location wise status too. And you're also able to set the audit priority here. In this audit priority, you'll be having three types of options, which is going to be low, high and medium. So, which means that this will help you to send the remainder emails. And this audit severity is, this also have three options, which is going to be low, medium and high here. And whether it is applicable or non-applicable, you'll be able to view in this. Now, quickly walking you through the audit model here. So, here, as an auditor, I'll prepare for an audit process. So let me quickly walk you through the audit process of ISO 27001, which have 114 artifacts. So putting as finance here, I'll put it as ISO demo 123. My objective will be to get certification. And the audit type will be internal. So I'll give a description about the ISO 27001. To get the audit process streamlined and certified. I'll define my library here as ISO 27001. Here I'll be able to define my locations. Now I'm giving it as Colombo. And the department, I'll give it as a sales department. And the team, I'll give it as the pre-sales department here. And the audit against whether it is going to be asset, process or people. So let me give it for the process here. And this start date and end date will help you to send the remainder emails. And the audit process. Maybe I'll set it for March 31st and okay, the starting date is today, which is 16th. And let me define the audit procedure here. So usually you type in big terms. To keep it cut short, I'll put it as all the data to be collected. Clear unused data. Get the approval. So once this process is done, I will assign the auditee here. I'm selecting it as employee 1 here. The auditor will be employee 0, which is me. So once I've done with this, I'll define the audit frequency, whether you want to have it as monthly or quarterly basis, half-yearly basis and yearly basis. So let me give it for the quarterly basis. And now I'm going to plan for the audit here. If you could find it, the plan status is being created. My task as an auditor is not yet over because I have to assign the particular artifacts to the auditees. So here, now I'm going to assign the particular task to the particular RET here. So let me give it through the priority as medium and the severity as high. The owner will be employee one. And for a kind of information, you can assign multiple RETs. So this is a process where the auditor gives a task to the multiple RETs under him. And I'll also set the target date. Okay, this will help you send the remainder emails. If the RET does not respond to the email, an escalation email can also be sent. Here, for each of the artifact, you'll have a questionnaire. So let me walk you through the information security policies and the management direction for information security is the artifact here. And for the artifact, you'll have a checklist. It is policies for information security. For the particular checklist, you will have multiple questionnaires. Like we have, are all the policies properly communicated to employees? Or all policies approved by the management? Here I'm assigning two questionnaires for the RET. You could see the control is being saved here. So let me also give it for the other process for operation security here. For the operation security, I'll give it for backup and the information backup here. I'm going to set the priority as high and severity also as high and the owner. And the remainder emails will be sent based upon the priority and the severity you set. And this is configurable at the backing that if it is want to be sent for everyday basis, the email, the remainder emails, or if you want to send it for 3 days once, so you can set that. And you can also assign the target date for the particular audit here. And here I'll set the questionnaires. I'm going to set, are the backups tested? Does the organization backup policy comply with relevant legal frameworks? So I'm going to save two of the controls here. And once the process is done, I have assigned the particular audit process and this the particular checklist to the RET A, which is employee one. Now I'm swapping in user as an RET or the employee one here. If you could find it, okay, so this dashboard overlook. So here in this list, so the RET, once the auditor assigns the task, the RET will be notified that the auditor has assigned the task through email. So here, let me go through it. And here, we have a two predefined functionalities. It is do and act. So let me explain one by one. So do will be the first task which is need to be done by the RET here. So as you could see, I have assigned two artifacts here. For the artifacts, I'll have the checklist as policies for information security. For each of the questionnaire, I will have an option called as yes or no. Whether I've completed, he'll give the option as yes and save it. And all the policies approved, I'm going to give this option also as yes and I'm going to save it. So let me give a negative review for the second, the operation security, the backup. So here I'm going to give a negative feedback as no and I'm going to save it. And for this particular option also, I'm going to give it as no. So once I'm done with the RET process, I've responded to the particular task assigned by the auditor. Now I'm swapping in user as an auditor here. So I'm done with the, okay, with assigning the task and I've also reverted with the response here from the RET. The auditor will be notified in the email that the RET has responded to the particular task. Now I'm going to check upon the responses given by the RET. So here I'm going to give the comment as satisfied. And the status as accepted here. And also here is done. And the status, I'll give it as accepted. So in this comment option, what I'm going to do, the tasks are accomplished. Maybe I'll put it as task is accomplished. Now I'm going to score the option. So this scoring model will help you check whether the status has been accepted or rejected. If I'm going to score lesser than 2, which means that is not allowable for the risk factor, and you have to work on it more. So now, since I'm satisfied with the task, I'm going to give the score as 4. And the overall status of the artifact, I'm going to give the option as accepted, and I'm going to save the particular response here. So meanwhile, for this, okay, for the operation security, the backup, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to give a negative comment as not satisfied, and the status as rejected. Meanwhile, for this, I'll put as more clarity required, and the status as rejected. The comment would be redo the task and submit before the deadline. Once I've done with it, I'm going to give the score as 2 here because I wanted the task to be redone. And I'm going to give the overall status as also as rejected, and I'm going to save the control. Now, as an auditor, I have submitted my responses provided by the auditee. So now the auditee will get the notification for the second task, that is going to be operation security. So now I'm swapping a user as an auditee. If you're going to go for the second predefined task, which is going to be act. If you could find it in the first task, the auditee will not be able to give his corrective or the primitive absence because he has given a positive response to it. So let me take it for the operation security backup. Here, now I'm going to give my option as yes or no, whether I've completed the task. Yes, I'll give my corrective action and the primitive actions. Data collected. And the corrective action is nil. And I'm going to give option as save. Now the checklist is saved here. Meanwhile, for this, I'm going to give it as yes, and the corrective actions is evidence is obtained, and I'm going to give the corrective actions as clear, and I'm going to save the option. So once I've done with it, as an auditee, my task is completed. Now I'm going to check for the particular task done by the auditee here. I'll go on for the option ISO demo 123, which I've given, and I'll go for the check option here. In this, I'll be listed with the particular option which I need to accept or reject it. So if you could see, this task is repeated unless and until the auditor is satisfied by the task that he has provided. So now I'm going to give the comment as good job, and I'm going to give the status as accepted here. So meanwhile, for this, I'll put as I'm satisfied, the status as accepted, and the comment is please ensure that it is done clear and fast manner. So once I've given this, I'll give a scoring model here. So now I'm going to give the score as 4, and I'm going to accept the particular status, and I'm going to save the responses. Now the auditee will be responded that the auditor has accepted the task. Now as an auditor, I have the rights to publish the particular artifacts done by the auditee. You could find it. I'll have a mini dashboard overlook stating with the responses and which has been set, and the auditor feedback here. So once I've done, I'll give my remarks as good here, and the observation as satisfied and ready for the external audit. And I'm going to give the publish option, and this is being published. So this will be reflected in the dashboard. So the process is, so this is a tool which will help simplify the process, if you could see. And that's all about the audit module. So meanwhile, in the next sessions, I'll go ahead with the assets and the complaints part. Thank you so much.